Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. There was another SpaceX launch with Starlink on a Falcon 9 rocket for the Starlink 33 mission.
Ignition. Lift off of the Falcon 9.
The booster which launched this mission, B1061, then landed successfully for the 10th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing burn.
Here's the start of our stage 1 entry burn. Beautiful view of that drone ship coming into view.
Terminal guidance. Stage 1 landing light deploy. Stage 1 landing is confirmed.
That was an amazing view of the first stage landing thanks to our Starlink satellites.
We can hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission this coming week as well. As you can see on the SpaceX Fans website, the launch of Starlink 427 is expected on Friday 19th at 7:24pm UTC or 3:24pm EDT. SpaceX posted a Starlink-related tweet saying Starlink is now available in Estonia. There was a cool tweet posted by Tesla related to SpaceX. It says, as a thank you to Tesla owners for referring a friend or family member, we invited them to submit images that were laser etched and launched into space by SpaceX's Falcon 9. There was an article posted about the FCC rejecting a request from SpaceX for subsidies. It says the Federal Communication Commission on Wednesday denied SpaceX's bid for nearly $1 billion in subsidies to support rural broadband customers through the company's Starlink satellite internet network. There was an article posted about ESA potentially launching with SpaceX rockets. It says the European Space Agency has begun preliminary technical discussions with SpaceX that could lead to the temporary use of its launchers after the Ukraine conflict blocked Western access to Russia's Soyuz rockets. There was an article posted related to SpaceX's Falcon Heavy being able to launch secret US payloads. It says SpaceX may soon handle some of the US government's highest priority satellite missions. Bloomberg reports the Space Force has certified SpaceX to launch top-secret spy satellites using Falcon Heavy rockets equipped with reusable boosters. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. Earthwork has been going on near the suborbital launch site. Julia Bergeron posted a tweet with a picture of the thumbnail of an NSF video. You can see the progress that's happened recently with the Star Factory at SpaceX's Roberts Road facility in Florida. There's been an immense amount of work on it. In addition to that, the tower next to the LC-39A pad is progressing nicely too. This picture was posted on Reddit of the progress on the Starship tower with six sections now stacked. This new E-dome was seen being moved in the yard. Ship 24 continues to be worked on the suborbital pad B mount. The very old B2.1 test tank was seen being worked on in the yard. On Thursday, SpaceX performed an exceptionally long static fire with Booster 7, which was 20 seconds long. With Booster 7 having completed another successful static fire, Elon Musk posted this picture of Booster 7 on Twitter performing the static fire. Musk posted a tweet in response to this with information about what the test was for. He said, about to attempt long duration engine firing to test autogenous pressurization. In relation to the static fire as well, SpaceX posted a cool picture of Booster 7 undergoing the static fire. They said, full duration 20 second static fire of Super Heavy Booster 7. After the second successful static fire, B7 was lifted off of the orbital launch mount. It was later rolled back to the production site for more work. After being rolled back to the production site, Musk posted a tweet with a video panning up Super Heavy Booster 7. He said, adding the 13 inner engines. Zach Golden posted an exciting tweet related to the installation of the remaining Raptor engines. He said, SpaceX moved 13 gimballing Raptor 2 engines to the megabay overnight. Booster 7 static fire testing must have exceeded expectations because they are now preparing to transport it back to production and quickly install the remaining engines. Taking a look at the closures on the Cameron County website, there are just a couple of dates this coming week. There are possible closures tomorrow, Monday 15th and Tuesday 16th for some more testing. The B7.1 test tank continues to be worked on in the mid bay. Booster 8 continues to be worked on in the mega bay. As always, I have to say thank you to both Mary, also known as Boca Chica Gal, and Nick Antsuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.